Hi friends, in this video I am going to start the Spring Boot session. Before going to Spring Boot, we should know some basic concept and we should know what is the Spring framework. And if you want to learn Spring Boot, you should know Java programming. Without Java programming, you cannot learn a Spring Boot. And the fourth point is good to know about the Solid JSP, but it's not required. If you want to know about that, there is a lot of things in the internet. Go and check it out. First one, I hope you people are already know Java programming. Yes. Second and third, I will go into cover. What is the basic concept we should know before going to Spring framework? What is loose coupling? What is dependence injection? What is inversion of control and auto wiring? To know about loose coupling, we should know about what is tight coupling. In this example, I have given one class called customer service. Customer service calling another class called customer data management. The customer data management is having one method called register method. Sorry, I want to do one correction here. I want to remove this parameter. Okay. Whenever called register method from customer data management, this will register a new customer. Okay, this method used by our customer service class. If you take any project, there is a one business layer. The business layer will do the business related process. That's what happening here. Customer service calling the data class called customer data management and call the register method for registration. Let's say I have a new requirement tomorrow. There is a new requirement comes from the client. Hey, I want to register two type of customer. As of now, we are registering only customer from India. I want to register customer from outside from India also. So I want to change my register method. In this case, currently the register method does not have any parameter. So I am deciding to add one more argument inside register method, which is customer type. Inside a customer data management, I am modifying the register method. So since I want to implement, make register method for registering from India as well as outside from India, I want to change registration logic. Let's say these are my customer data management class. Inside that class, I have a register method. Now I'm adding one more parameter. One parameter here that is called a customer type. Based on the customer type, my registration logic will go here. Okay. Since I added a new parameter, I need to add the parameter type whenever I call the register method. This is the problem with tight coupling. Tight coupling means whenever you change your method implementation, wherever you are calling, in that place also, in those place also, we have to change. That is called tight coupling. These are one of the drawback of tight coupling. Now I don't want to change. Whatever improvement, whatever changes I am doing in my method, I don't want to change anything here. If you want to write a code like that, if you write a code like that, that is called as loose coupling. How do you implement loose coupling code? We'll go to see now. In this code snippet, customer data management, I'm making as an interface. Customer data management making as an interface. Then this interface having one method declared register. Now I want to give implementation of the register method in two different classes. One is customer data management local, another one is customer data management international. Both the classes implemented customer data management. Okay. The customer data management local having a logic for registering a people from India, customer data management international having a logic for registering a people from outside from India. Now coming back to customer service, the customer service method, I want to call the register method. That method work for both both customer, that is from India as well as international. Okay, for that what I'm doing here, public customer service, I'm passing the interface type in the constructor. I'm passing the interface type inside the constructor. Whenever you call this constructor by passing customer data management local type inside interface object, this register method register the people from India. Whenever I pass customer data management international type inside the interface type, this register method will do the registration for outside from India. Through this way, I don't have to change anything here. Whatever logic you are doing in the data access layer, I don't have to do any changes whenever you're calling this method. This is called as a loose coupling. This loose coupling extensively used in the Spring framework. We'll go to see those things detailed when I talk about that. Next one is, what is dependency injection and what is inversion of control? Dependency injection is a dependency with one class with another class. If you take a previous example, customer data management is a class that used by customer service. So customer service always dependent with customer data management type of classes. Okay, without that it cannot register a new customer. This is called as a dependency management. How the dependency is maintained in the Spring framework? There is a three different annotation in the Spring framework: add service, add component, and add auto wire. Through this annotation, Spring framework maintaining the dependency management. What is the purpose of add service, add component, add auto wire? If any classes annotated with add service, that class taken care by your Spring framework. If any class annotated with add component, that class taken care by, controlled by your Spring framework. If any classes declared with add auto wire, that particular object initialization or that particular object controlled by Spring framework. Okay, now here in this example, business layer annotated with add service class, data access layer also annotated with add service class. Let's say there is another class called data access layer that also annotated with add service class. Now I want to use add data access layer inside the business layer, so I need to use add auto wire followed by data access layer declaration. When we start the Spring application, your Spring framework searches the classes with annotated with add service, add component. Okay, it pick all those classes, it pick all those classes and put those classes inside a container. That container is called as the IOC container. Okay, whenever use any classes in the program, your Spring framework pick that classes and give it to that particular classes automatically by the Spring framework. We don't have to do anything. In this example, business layer uses data access layer, right? So your Spring framework take them data access layer object from the IOC container, give it to your business layer classes. Here developer not maintaining the initializing the classes, everything maintained by your IOC container, everything controlled by your IOC container. So we are call it as an inversion of control. Okay, now we're going to see what is Spring framework, what is the role of IOC container. Before going into the Spring framework, what is the role of IOC container? In previous, when I explained the previous slide itself, you should understand what is the role of IOC container. Okay. Role of IOC containers, find a bins, wire bin dependencies. Wire bin dependency means the business layer annotated with at service class. Whenever you say at auto wire, your spring framework wire this data access layer inside the business layer class. This is called as wire bin dependencies. And the destroy bin man, destroy bins. Destroy bin means after completion of use of particular bin, Spring framework take a responsibility to, that is Spring IOC container take a responsibility to destroy the bins. This is the role of IOC container. This is, we call it as life cycle of bins inside a IOC container. To get IOC container, there are two strategies. One is bin factory, another one is application context. Using bin factory, we can get a IOC container, we can manage the bin. We can manage the bin. That is, we can get the IOC container manage the bin inside the IOC container. We can do that only using bin factory. If you get a IOC container through application context, application context IOC container manage the bin as well as it provides some more feature that is called as aspect oriented programming, then IITN, that is internationalization and managing the web application context, that is like session requests, web context, those things. So apart from managing a bin, your application context IOC container, that is IOC container coming from application context, that gives some additional feature. Aspect oriented programming I'm going to teach later, internationalization I'll go and teach later, then web applications, managing the web applications. This thing I'm going to cover upcoming videos. This is the difference between bin factory and application context. Okay, but when you work with Spring Boot, we don't have to care about this. This thing will taken care by Spring Boot itself. But you should know what is the bin factory, what is the application context. These things are very useful when you attend the interviews. Next one is, we're going to talk about Spring Framework. What is the feature of Spring Framework? How you can say this is the advantages of Spring Framework when compared to non-Spring Framework project. We're going to talk about that later, in the next video. As well as we're going to compare how we can compare Spring Framework with Spring Boot. Okay, until then, bye bye from Suresh Kesavan. If you like this video, please share this. I'm going to cover full Spring Boot as well as Spring Cloud microservice. So please share this video, share this channel to your friends and colleagues who wanted to learn Spring Boot and microservices using Spring Cloud.